The lifting of the international embargo on the purchase of weapons by Iran could lead to the fact that Tehran will begin to acquire air defense, and fighters from Moscow and Beijing, learned BulgarianMilitary.com. According analysts Bradley Bowman and Shane Pricewater of the Foundation for the Defense of Democracies, and their article in Breaking Defense magazine. The publication notes that in 2019 Iran made attempts to acquire the S-400 Triumph from Russia, but the latter rejected this offer. But if the arms embargo ends, Moscow could seize the opportunity to sell Tehran the S-400, as well as fighters and other weapons, suggests Breaking Defense. The publication notes that, given the impending dangers, the United States, Department of Defense and the Israel Defense Forces are preparing for whatever, possible, might happen. As an example of such training, Breaking Defense cites the joint exercises of the military departments of the countries to practice the F-35 Lightning II strikes against complex air defense systems and enemy fighters before the upcoming defeat of ground targets. The fight will be interesting, the best fighter in the world, according to the USA, against the best anti-aircraft missile system to date. This is a generally accepted opinion. This is not even a test, but a test of the combat qualities of an aircraft made using stealth technology, which must overcome the S-400 defense system and prove the superiority of the F-35. A risky venture, but if successful, the United States will receive a kind of quality mark for a fighter whose reputation has been tarnished more than once. And if the fight takes place, then the S-400 will also have the opportunity in real conditions to confirm its capabilities in detecting and destroying a rather complex aerial target. Lightning versus Triumph, bet on it, gentlemen. Israel as a test bench was not chosen by chance. The combat aircraft of this countiel periodically inflicts airstrikes on Syria, on objects where, as they believe in Tel Aviv, Hezbollah and Iranian military units are located. From the Israeli Nevadim F-35 air base, they can carry out tasks without refueling in the airspace of Jordan, Lebanon and Syria, in most of Egypt and Iran, as well as in parts of the territories of Saudi Arabia and Turkey. The Israeli Air Force already has 20 F-35 fighters and is ready to order a batch of 25 more of these aircraft to replace existing ones. At the same time, they are considering the possibility of acquiring modernized F-15 fighters as more reliable and efficient. Therefore, the United States in practice intends to demonstrate to the partners the combat capabilities of the F-35 precisely in overcoming modern air defense systems. In general, the place for testing was chosen almost perfect. Whether Israel will be happy to participate in the battle with the S-400 is a big question. The alleged attack should go to the Russian base in Khmeimim, which the Israelis had not previously allowed themselves. In addition, this countiel already had experience of losing the F-35, which participated in airstrikes on the territory of Syria. According to a military source in the US, there is no reason for the F-35 to be afraid of Russian air defense systems, especially the S-400 system deployed in Syria. This is indicated by the fact that the F-35 continues to operate near Syria, despite the S-400, and perhaps the S-400 is worth the fear of the capabilities of the F-35. In early January this year, the United States struck a car with terrorists near the Syrian-Iranian border. However, the message did not come from Washington, but directly from Russian Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov. Following this incident, Vasington did not deny the news, but recognizing the visibility of the F-35 for the S-400 air defense system, they declare the following: the ability to detect F-35 fighters does not mean the possibility for the S-400 to bring them down. It is added that, in such a situation, the F-35 will destroy the S-400 anti-aircraft missile system using the electronic jamming system.